Dear aviators, you're high above the main ridge of the Alps. The day is coming to an end and you're still 70 kilometers away from your home airfield. There are still many peaks and valleys to pass, and one single question is keeping your mind busy. Will I make it home? This is the moment of truth in every cross-country flight. The final glide. This moment always makes my pulse race. Why? Because I have only one try to bring that glider back home. No second attempts, no go rounds. And my eyes want to tell me I won't reach home. Way too far, too many mountains in between. But if I trust the math, the numbers confirm that I've got this. It's a thrilling struggle between disbelief of what I see and the incredible physics of gliding. Let me share this unique experience with you in this video, and you'll get insights into managing a final glide, and even more, you'll witness these exciting moments directly from the cockpit. Welcome on board and enjoy! The following methods are personal and very basic, but they've worked well many times for me, and most probably for other beginner or intermediate pilots too. Setting up an ambitious final glide like in a competition is a completely different story and art. But if you're interested in witnessing basic decision-making in the cockpit and experiencing the incredible performance of a glider, you're in the right place. Here I am at the main ridge at the Zillertal after a 500 km cross-country flight, which took me from Unterwössern airfield to Trieben in Austria and close to Sterzing in Italy. The perfect weather that day allowed for high-speed soaring and breathtaking views over the vast rocks of the main ridge. Now it's 5 p.m, time to turn home. The point of departure, 3,200 meter above mean sea level, 70 km to the airfield and flying wings with a glide performance of up to 1 to 40. Method number one, the glide computer. Let's start with the obvious. The device constantly calculates the predicted arrival altitude. I set my personal minimum, plus 800 meters above the airfield. Now I have 1,300 above the airfield, so that's a lot of safety margin. But there's still many ridges to cross and winds might work against me. If the number is green and within my margin, that's green light number one for my final glide. But the conditions may change during the final glide, so I watch carefully. Is the predicted arrival going up or dropping? That's why I constantly compare the required glide path with the actual glide path. Let me show you how that works. As long as this number is higher, I'm safe. If it gets equal or lower, I might not make it, and I start to search for lifting air or even prepare for an outlanding. Here it's even going up, most probably because I've hit energy lines and avoided sinking air masses. That even allows me to push the stick and pick up speed. Method number two, the brain only backup. I always run this mental calculation as a backup, not to replace the computer, but to verify it. Distance by 4, then add a 0, that gives the required altitude to bring the ship home. 70 kilometers by 4 is 280, so I need 2800 meters to reach home. This is based on a safety-orientated glide ratio of 1 to 25. Realistic and safe for the unpredictable alpine conditions. It's so simple that even when your brain is tired, it gives you a quick and helpful estimate. I initiated the final glide from 3200 meters above mean sea level. Based on a quick calculation, I'd reach around 400 meters, clearly below the airfield elevation of 555 meters. Still, the active cumulus ahead and confidence in the glider's 1 to 40 glide ratio gave me the go ahead. It was a bit tight, but acceptable given the day's condition and still within safety margins. So, a yellow light and something to monitor. Okay, let's keep going for the last method, number 3, geography and experience. There's something no computer or calculation can replace: experience. Over time, I've built a mental map of checkpoints and their ideal flyover altitudes. Check out my video about a low-level final glide for more on that. Here I am passing the mountain Gernkogel in 2000 meter, 15 kilometers away from the airfield and well above minimum glide path. Now it's time to keep constantly tracking whether all green lights of the three methods stay green. If any turn yellow or red, I must update the plan. Find lift, reduce speed, or prepare to land at a nearby paddock or airfield. Please note, I always know my escape plan throughout the entire final glide. On this route, I have 1-3 airfields and more than 2-5 outlanding fields within reach always. Even if things go wrong, I'm never without a place to land. And then, the most beautiful moment, the airfield appears. From what once felt absolutely impossible, you arrive, high enough, safe, and with a quiet sense of deep satisfaction. Even high enough to stretch the final glide over the beautiful Lake Chiemsee. These are the moments when gliding feels like magic. But it's not magic. It's planning, it's training, it's trust. In these moments, you get a taste of the pioneering spirit of engineers and pilots who designed these aircrafts. The essence of aviation itself. The human ability to outgrow themselves and reach places they never believed they could. And as always, take care, fly safe, and see you next time.